guys, and welcome back to Man Cave Collectibles, coming at you today with another figure review. Today we're going to take a look at the Superman figure from Mayfex. This is from the Batman Hush storyline that they're kind of running with in the Mayfex line right now. This is based on Jim Lee artwork, so when I seen that, obviously I could not say no. Anything that Jim Lee does that they can put in figure form, I think, is always going to be a win. And I've actually even considered, could this be our definitive Superman figure in the 6-inch scale line? So that's something you guys can also give me your opinion on in the comments below as we go through this review. Let's go ahead and jump right into the box itself. We got a product shot here of the actual figure. Obviously, the window packaging, we can see Superman and a lot of the accessories that he comes with. One of his hands looks like it's kind of falling out of its spot there. We got some Mayfex branding and DC branding here in the bottom. Another product shot up top. Another product shot on the side. On the back, we get multiple product shots here of Superman and some of the accessories that he comes with. For example, looks like we got some ivy here, from Poison Ivy, that we can wrap around different areas of his body. A couple heads that shows here the options. Little product imaging on that side. And back to the front. Let's go ahead and get this guy to his packaging and see what we got. All right, guys, so we got Superman out of his packaging and onto the review table and looking fantastic. Getting him out of package just really solidifies the purchase that I made with this guy. Let's jump right into accessories. So we'll take a look here at the hands first. We've got multiple pairs of hands here, from flat, holding, relaxed. We've got an additional set of fisted hands that are slightly different, and I'll show you what I mean by that. If you look at the hands that are actually on him right now, you can see that the fist, the thumb specifically, is very balled up and kind of, it's all sculpted together. But if you look at this additional fist hand that they gave us, you can see that the thumb is not sculpted into the four fingers. There's a slight bit of space in there. So that's kind of cool, just a little bit different, you know, as far as how you want your fist hands to appear. So that's pretty neat. Now we also get, this would be as if you picked up your Batman figure. So during the Batman-Superman fight, when Poison Ivy had control of Superman, Batman was able to use a kryptonite ring. So they actually include this in. So if you have picked up the Batman Hush Mayfex figure, which I think I will probably be doing that now after seeing this one, you can get the additional accessory for him here in the Superman. Now we also get the vines that Poison Ivy kind of move around. They don't particularly look exactly in the fashion that these will be molded, but he kind of constantly had vines kind of around him as Poison Ivy had control of him. So we've got one here for like his neck area, for his wrist area here. So these look pretty good. They're just painted plastic. Real kind of a soft material, no bendy wire or anything in them, but they're just made to go around the wrist and then, you know, up there around the neck or even the head. However you want to do this one is fine, but pretty cool little addition there. And then lastly, you can see that we do have a face sculpt on where Superman has his blue eyes, and he's kind of in a stoic look, but we get an additional head sculpt here where he's very angry and his eyes are red. So I think that's pretty cool. Not sure how well the red eyes are showing up. It's very small, but you know, it looks really, really nice. And you know, this would be from that scene where him and Batman end up fighting during the time of Poison Ivy's control. He actually kind of starts the fight off with using his optic blast. Not optic blast, that would be Cyclops, but using his heat vision or laser vision to kind of attack Catwoman and Batman. So yeah, really, really nice head sculpt here. They did a great job there on the teeth area and just the sculpt in general. The hair looks fantastic. They really nailed this Jim Lee look. And then the last thing here, we do get the base, the Mayfex base, just a clear plastic base with the arm and the kind of wraparound hook there if you wanted to do flight poses or anything like that. So that's always a nice addition when companies add a base in. All right, let's jump straight into our Superman figure and taking a closer look at this guy. So just so you guys can kind of see that head sculpt, you can see there the blue eyes, turned down mouth a little bit, but the hair and all kind of appears to be the same exact sculpt. Really not much difference as far as that's concerned. They kind of put a little bit of a blue tone or a blue highlight into that hair to kind of give it a little more of that comic book look. So that's, I always like that. If you're going for the comic book look, go ahead and go all out. But yeah, look at that. Just profiles perfect. Just straight Jim Lee. You can you know, see the Jim Lee in this thing everywhere. Did a pretty good job here on my S logo. Everything lines up really well, even where the plastic kind of changes here. They did a pretty good job of lining up those reds. It's really not messy in there, which I like. Sometimes those can, when you go from one piece of plastic to another, you know, you can, those lines may not match up really. I've seen where some guys have had some issue with some rub here in this area. Mine does not seem to have that yet. Maybe it could be something that comes at some point, but it's not something I'm seeing at this time. We do have bendy wire here in our cape area. So, you know, you're able to bend and mold that cape to your liking. Flipping on around to the back there, you can see we got that S logo on the cape. The cape is a real nice material. It feels very durable. It doesn't feel like it's going to tear or rip, really, you know, degrade too much over time. So that's very nice. As always with Mafex, they do a pretty good job here, you know, in the joint areas, just making those clean and nice looking. And moving on down, got those trunks there, the yellow belt, just such an iconic looking Superman we got here. Really the only QC issue that I could really point out on mine, I do have a little bit of a kind of a red little scratch or a mark there. Looks like some of the red paint maybe just got a little bit out of its place. But looks good. And then getting on down to the red boots, just perfectly done here. I think this is a excellent looking figure so far from what I can tell. Really, really happy that I went ahead and grabbed this guy. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at the articulation on Superman. All right, so taking a look here, we can get that head all the way down. I've got the chin touching the chest. So, I mean, you know, that's perfect. As far as looking up for the kind of those flight poses, we can get up decent amount, maybe not full speed ahead type up, but it's a pretty good. Plenty of range of motion left to right. We can get the confused look very easy on both sides, so no problems there. We do have kind of that butterfly shoulder joint in there, so that's going to really allow for a ton of range of motion there in that arm. We can get those arms up to about right there with no issue. Full 360, no problem. Bicep cut, double jointed elbows. You can see that all the motion you need in there. Wrist, kind of same thing you would come to expect from Mafex. Looks good. Full 360 on it. And moving on into the abdominal area here, we get a good bit of ab crunch if you kind of combine the two. Most of the crunch seems to come from kind of the waist area more so than the chest area, but either way, it's still going to give you that crunch. And then for flight poses, you can get all you need. And that almost, you know, gets that face kind of up straight so you can kind of fly, you know, like he's flying straight ahead. Looks really good. And then as we kind of discussed there, here in the lower abdomen, we can get, you know, plenty of range of motion in that. Get those legs out to about right there comfortably. That will swivel at the top of that thigh. No cut in the thigh here. Double jointed knees for days. Perfectly done. And then down here, no cut in the calf area. And then your standard Mafex articulation here in the feet, toes. Plenty of rocker going either way. So yeah, the Mafex articulation to me is always a win. I'm always very pleased with it. I've had a lot of Mafex figures kind of in my collection, in and out. I've had them, sold them. But I don't collect a whole lot of DC figures. And when I saw, again, kind of like we discussed earlier, when I saw this guy, and he's kind of, you know, he's kind of coming out of one of my favorite comic books storylines, figured I better pick this guy up. So we'll probably go ahead and pick up the Batman to go with him as well. All right, let's take a quick look here at the accessories kind of placed on the figure. So you can kind of see how we have, you know, these vines wrapped in their respective areas. As far as the wraps here on the wrist, I did find that you need to take off the hand in order to kind of slide that up on the wrist. This one, no need. It has a cut in it, so you're able to just kind of wrap it around his neck and move on from there. But this is really cool. If this is something you want, you know, it'll be interesting to see if we get a Poison Ivy figure. If we do, that can make for some really, really neat poses and action figure photography, things like that. I think this would play into the hands of a, you know, an action figure photographer fantastically if we can get that Poison Ivy figure. And I'm sure we will. They're really kind of moving through that hush line. We do have the additional head sculpt on there as well that you can see. That is the angry face sculpt there. And again, you know, we just kind of, the difference with that is he does have those red eyes and then kind of clenching his teeth in there. So it just looks really, really nice. I actually like this. If I had a Poison Ivy, this may be the way that I would pose this guy. So yeah, let me know what you think. How are you be posing your Superman? Will you be posing him kind of as Poison Ivy's minion, or are you going to pose him kind of more as the good guy Superman? Let's go ahead and bring in a couple other figures for size comparison, and we'll wrap up this video. All right, guys, and just a couple other Supermans here for size comparison. We got the newly released Mezco 112 Christopher Reeve Superman, and we've got kind of an older DC Direct Superman, which I've always kind of liked in my collection. You can see, obviously, he's in that 6-inch scale, not the 7-inch scale, as like our DC Direct would be over here. So just a little size comparison there with a couple other of his kind of Superman counterparts. Grab a couple other figures. Okay, and here he is with kind of another standard 6-inch Spider-Man Marvel Legend figure, and then a SH Figure Arts Michael Keaton Batman figure from the 1989 movie. So we can see SH Figure Arts always coming in super small. That's really my only problem with that line. Even though I do like the look of this figure, we did the custom cape and everything. You can see just it's too small to even pose there with your Mafex figures. But there he is, guys, from a size comparison standpoint, just to kind of give you a little bit of a feel for where he stacks up. If you guys enjoyed this video, hit that like button. If you're not a subscriber, consider subscribing to the channel. Would love to have you as part of the Man Cave Collectibles team. Drop those comments down below. What do you think of this figure? Is this the definitive Superman figure in 6-inch form? I can't say that it is at this point, but I really, really like this figure. It is definitely a recommend from me if you're a Superman fan, especially if you are a Mafex fan. And then obviously, if you're a Jim Lee fan. So this kind of hits a lot of points here from a collector standpoint. I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. Until next time.